In this video, I'm going to show you what the Google Chat API is and how to use it. Hi, I'm Chanel, a developer advocate at Google. If you're curious how you can programmatically access Google Chat, well then this video is for you. The Google Chat API is a RESTful API that gives you the ability to programmatically access Google Chat. With the API, it is possible to perform create, read, update, delete, and list operations on spaces, memberships, messages, attachments, and reactions. How might this be useful? Let's have a look at three common scenarios where the Google Chat API will prove to be helpful. Some organizations use more than one messaging solution, and they need a way for these messengers to coexist. The Chat API enables interoperability between Google Chat and any other messenger that has an API. When an organization adopts Google Chat, they usually need a way to migrate the information located on the previous messenger. The Chat API allows to programmatically recreate the channels and memberships and bring historical conversations into Google Chat. The Chat API enables developers to build their own tools and workflows on top of Google Chat. This capability can be used when organizations want to connect, for example, their incident management system to Google Chat to programmatically create a Google Chat space and add the relevant team members to the space whenever an incident is escalated. To get started using the Google Chat API, you will need a Google account and access to the Google Cloud Platform Console. In the following videos of this series, you will learn about the difference between calling the API as a user versus an app, and when each is appropriate. You'll learn the core concepts of spaces and memberships in Google Chat, including how to create direct messages, group conversations, and manage rosters. Lastly, you'll learn the basics of messages, attachments, and reactions using the Google Chat API. You can find additional information about the Google Chat API in the description below. And by the way, how about you leave us a like if you've learned something new in this video? And subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos about Google Workspace development.